24 hours.
Your interactive source for progressive news and commentary.
7 days a week.
He snapped at one of his critics and said that the Constitution is just a damn piece of paper.
Thanks for watching Go Left TV. Citizens Media, on the rise.
Welcome back to Ring of Fire. I'm Robert F. Kennedy Jr. Right now, we're talking with former Alabama Governor Don Siegelman about the latest updates in his case and whether or not Congress, with its larger Democratic majorities, will be able to investigate the scandals of the Bush Justice Department. So, Governor Siegelman, go ahead with your story. You were telling us about Karl Rove's roots in the state, about your long history of battles with him and his, and how you were involved with his first theft of an election, which occurred actually in Alabama. What happened after your after the election was stolen from you?
Well, I got ready to run for office again, and with that, the political machinery went to work to try to make sure that I was politically damaged before the election. I was indicted and brought to trial 1 month before the Democratic primary election by the wife of my opponent's campaign manager, who was a old business friend and political associate of Karl Rove's. I was sentenced to prison. My sentence was enhanced for speaking out about the political origins of my case, and I was sent to a maximum security prison, put in solitary confinement, and eventually released after 9 months of being in prison by, I think, an extraordinary ruling of the 11th Circuit Court of Appeals, who said that there were substantial questions of both law and fact that would likely result in a reversal. 54 former state attorneys general from all over the country weighed in on my side, saying that what I'd been accused of was not a crime. So we're hopeful that the 11th Circuit will agree with the 54 former state attorneys general, and they will give me a clean bill of health soon. But more importantly than me, Bobby, I know our time is short. More importantly than my case is getting at the truth of who hijacked our Department of Justice and who used it as a political tool, not just in my case, but in the firing of the U.S. attorneys and in multiple other cases that have appeared around the country that look and smell like politics. Fortunately, Nancy Pelosi has recently said that that it wasn't up to Congress anymore, that we just can't let this politicizing of the Department of Justice go unreviewed, and that she wants the truth to come out. John Conyers has now issued another subpoena for Karl Rove, and so that the timing is good. The focus of Congress is back on this issue of seeking the truth, and getting Karl Rove to testify is an important first step.
One of the recent developments in your case, which is encouraging from your point of view and from America's point of view, is that the key witness, Nick Bailey, who provided the cornerstone testimony upon which your conviction was based, has now been convicted of extortion and given 10 years in prison. And Bailey has now agreed to cooperate with prosecutors to lighten his own sentence. And one of the things that he has now acknowledged is that he engaged in 70 unpermitted interviews with your prosecutors during your case, and that Laura Canary and her staff never disclosed those to you. And that seems like reversible error from the outset. And just, I mean, it sounds like something that happens in the Soviet Union.
Well, we also have a Time magazine expose that talks about how this was selective prosecution. And we recently had another whistleblower come forward who said that the prosecutor, Bill Canary's wife, who supposedly stepped aside from the case, never did, that she stayed involved in the prosecution all the way up to and including the sentencing, and that there were there was an illegal investigation of jurors conducted behind our back, and that there were notes passed from the juror through the marshals to the prosecution during the course of the trial. So the case is replete with, I think, with reversible error. But again, I'm hopeful about my case, I'm more hopeful because of what John Conyers has done and Nancy Pelosi has said, that Congress will keep fighting and pushing and until we know the full extent of the abuse of power and who all was involved in that abuse of power.
You know, one of the things that's come out is that Laura Canary, who recused herself publicly from this case, which of course was the proper thing to do, as you say, although she publicly recused herself, she continued to direct the case secretly to her subordinates who were prosecuting you. And she, a series of emails has now emerged in which she has conversations with them where she is micromanaging the case. But one of the things that she does is that in one of these emails, she tells her subordinate, she refers to a poll that was taken that you had publicly said, which showed that 67% of Alabamans believe that your investigation was politically motivated. And here's her email. She says, you all need to read, because he refers to a survey which allegedly shows that 67% of Alabamians believe the investigation of him to be politically motivated. Perhaps this is grounds not to let Siegelman discuss court activities with the media. That's quote, end quote. So what she's trying to do is to muzzle you, not only to stop you from defending yourself in court, but to muzzle your public statements and get a court to order you to muzzle your public statements.
And shortly after that, the judge granted a motion in limine that basically said we couldn't raise politics as a defense in the courtroom. He didn't say that I couldn't talk about it outside of the courtroom, so I continued to talk about it outside of the courtroom. And of course, once I was convicted, he increased my sentence for talking about the political connections outside of the courtroom. Now we have, of course, sworn testimony that everything I said outside of the courtroom was in fact true, that Karl Rove was involved and that Bill Canary, the prosecutor's husband, was involved in getting the Department of Justice to pursue me. So it's all an interesting story, but I think the most important thing that your listeners can do is to pick up the phone, call John Conyers, pick up the phone and call Nancy Pelosi, fax them a note so they'll have something before them. Thank them for what they're doing and their efforts to reach the truth and finding out who hijacked our Department of Justice, who abused their power. Urge them to hold these people accountable so that this kind of behavior is less likely to happen again in the future. Romeo and-